Hi viewers, welcome to my video. Today we are going to talk about safety, which is the main priority for everyone. What the safety mean is, safety mean to protect yourself from any potential damage or any potential hazard. So you can see in the pictures, like, the people, they are not using safety practices, they are not following the safety practices, and which can lead to severe accidents and severe health damages. So this is the example. And in the safety, when we are talking about the road safety, when we are talking about the bikes, that the bike that is considered the most unsafe ride, if you are not properly following the safety precautions, like you're not wearing the helmet or the safety suit, then it can cause severe health injuries. So here you can see the girl who is following all the safety precautions, and she is wearing the helmet and the safety suit and traveling on the bike very easily on the mountains and on the rough roads, and she is safe. While on the other side, a person who is not properly following the safety equipments for riding on a bike, so the person, it leads to a severe health injury due to the accidents. So when we talk about here, we will be talking about the biosafety. The main focus will be on the biosafety. So first of all, we will see what the biosafety is. Biosafety is the prevention biosafety is to prevent the person, laboratory, or the surrounding environment from any exposure to the infectious agents or biohazards. So we can say that biosafety is protecting the person, the laboratory, and the surrounding environment from any potential infectious agent. So containment conditions under which infectious agents can be safely manipulated, it also make the biosafety. Containment is the basic principle of the biosafety. So what this containment is? The containment is to keep or to limit the infectious agent to certain region, or we can say this is the series of practices, good laboratory practices for managing the infectious agents in the laboratory. So it means that the series of proper good laboratory practices that you are using to prevent the person's laboratory or the surrounding environment from those infectious agents is called containment. It means that to limit the bacteria or the infectious agent. So there are two levels of the containment. One is the primary containment, and the second level is the secondary containment. In the primary containment, the main focus is to protect the person who is working with that infectious agent and the immediate laboratory environment from the exposure to infectious agent. While in the secondary containment, the main focus is more expanded, and it also includes to protect the external environment to the laboratory. So in the secondary containment, although we will be preventing the person who is working with the infectious agent and the immediate laboratory environment, but in the secondary containment, our focus will be also to the external environment to the laboratory. There are three elements of the containment. If you are using a good laboratory practices and using a safety equipment to handle that infectious agent, and using a proper facility design for the laboratory, so then you can work with these infectious agents, and these are three elements of the containment. There are four levels of biosafety. You may have heard these about these levels a lot, but here we will be explaining in a bit simpler way that what these levels are and what sort of microbes are worked with in these laboratory levels, safety levels. So in the biosafety level one, so there are four biosafety levels: biosafety level 1, 2, 3, and 4. And the severity, or the we can say that the potential of risk increases from laboratory 1 to the laboratory 4. So in the BSL 1, biosafety level 1, that is a suitable, the labs which are following the biosafety level 1, that are of biosafety level 1, they are suitable to work with the agents that do not cause disease or they can cause a minimal potential hazard. So usually they do not cause disease, or they can cause a very, very, very mild disease, like which is not a very much painful, or which is not a very much worrisome for the patient. So in this laboratory, or in at this biosafety level one, these good laboratory practices, usually standard microbiological practices, they are enough to handle these microorganisms. And we can even work with these we can work with these microorganisms on the bench tops. So special containment equipments like laminar flow hoods or some other biosafety cabinets, they are not required for the biosafety level one. And biosafety level one is really good to make the people trained to the microbiological techniques. But when the students will be getting training in the BSL one for the microbiological techniques, then a supervisor must be supervising those students. And if they need any help, and if they need any medical assistance, then that assistance should be provided immediately. So this is a simplest laboratory design for the biosafety level one. This is a facility design which is acceptable for the biosafety level one. So here you can see that there is no autoclave, and the person is working on the bench top, and the biosafety the waste bins, there are only two waste bins. One is for the ordinary waste and one is for the infectious waste. And there are some labels of biohazard. And this is the simplest facility design for the biosafety level one. Next, we will be moving to the biosafety level two. Biosafety level two is suitable to work with the agents that pose moderate risk to the person or to the environment. Or we can say to the immediate person who is working with that infectious agent, or the other persons who are working in that environment. The BSL two laboratory design, the persons who will be working at the biosafety level 2, they must have some specific training in handling those hazardous agents, and they must be supervised. The access to the laboratory should be restricted, and when the persons are working, then all the procedures for which all the procedures which involve the infectious agents or the infectious aerosols, they must be conducted in the biosafety cabinets. And the laboratory persons must be provided medical surveillance, and laboratory equipment should be routinely decontaminated to protect the persons from any potential infection. And the laboratory safety manual should be placed in the laboratory at the biosafety level 2 to inform, or if the persons they need help about any specific infectious agents, like what a sort of potential hazard it can pose, so that they can take help from those laboratory safety manual. So in the biosafety level 2, the facility design is a bit advanced, and here you can see that we can spot an autoclave here, and then the biohazard sign and waste bins are here. The person is working with the biosafety cabinet, and she is wearing the gloves and the lab coat and the goggles, and there is a fume hood as well. So next is the biosafety level 3. Biosafety level 3 is a bit more advanced, and it and the microorganisms with which we will work with in the biosafety level 3, they can pose a severe risk, or we can work if we are working with microorganisms with a moderate risk, but the volumes are larger that we are handling. So we should shift from biosafety level 2 to biosafety level 3. And in this laboratory, all the practices that we follow for the BSL level 1 and 2, they are applied. And other than this, some additional protective measures are taken. Like here in the facility design, you can see that this is a double door laboratory. So when the person will enter from this door, then the person will get change, and the person will totally change its clothes, and then it will then he or she or the scientist or the researcher who is working with those microorganisms will enter the laboratory. And in the laboratory, all the signs and the labels for the biohazards are properly placed, and the persons who will be working with these microorganisms will be wearing a proper personal protective equipments. Next is the biosafety level 4. Biosafety level 4 is the maximum containment laboratory, and in this the persons work with those microorganisms which are very infectious, and or they can cause disease for which no vaccine or cure is available. Are the microorganisms, they are of unknown infectivity or the pathogenicity, so they can be lethal. So usually the BSL4 laboratories are made in the isolated buildings, and they have their specialized ventilation system and waste management system. Even the air that just go out in the environment, then that air is firstly it is properly filtered, and then it is released in the environment. So there are two models for the biosafety level 4. Biosafety level 4 laboratories, they are based on the class 3 cabinet model, and the second is the suit lab model. In the class 3 cabinet lab model, all the work is done in biosafety class 3 cabinet. So in this cabinet is a very very closed cabinet, and there is a little autoclave, and so whenever something is entered from here, or we can say it's a little decontaminator, so whenever something enters in this biosafety cabinet, it firstly it is decontaminated, and whenever we are taking out something from this biosafety cabinet, that is also decontaminated before releasing in the laboratory. So here are gloves, and the person who is working with the pathogenic microorganisms, it is not he or she is not in direct contact with those microorganisms. And the second model is the suit lab model, in which the person who work with these pathogenic microorganisms wear a positively pressured suit which protect the person from those microorganisms, because this positively pressured suit it pushes away the microorganisms, and it do not allow the microorganisms to enter the suit or to reach the person. And the facility design for this biosafety level 4 is a bit more complicated and is a bit more advanced. It has its proper ventilation system and waste management system. The person who is entering in the laboratory is first decontaminated, and then if the person is leaving the laboratory, and the person is again decontaminated before the person can come out from this laboratory. So there is a picture that shows that how the scientists they work there. This picture shows the suit lab model for the biosafety level 4. So these were the four biosafety levels or the laboratories that we today talked about. So the main focus was on the biosafety, and then we talked about the containment, and then the biosafety levels. Hopefully you enjoyed the lecture. For more lectures, keep watching my videos. Till then, goodbye.